You know, as many of you know who have, you know, everyone who has kids in the program, it's a very hard year. You know, a lot of different things have been happening. And we're just very grateful that, you know, now we have the ability to have a concert indoors. And, you know, we can continue to move towards normalcy. And we thank the Presbyterian Church for allowing us to do that. So thank you very much, Mason, for all of you. The other people I need to thank also for this concert, especially, is our administration of Curwensville. You know, we are very blessed to have an administration that really supports what we do and to allow us to do these kinds of concerts and to have these events, you know, just in general, and to be able to produce the great things that we do. If you've never stepped foot into a Curwensville administration or anything like that, you know it's a very special place. And, you know, when I started working there, I never really knew a lot about Curwensville and what it had to offer. I knew kind of that it existed. That was pretty much what I knew. And it had good teachers. That's pretty much what it was. And then when you step into it, you realize it's a really special place to be. And that's what's really, really great about it. So we're very, very thankful for that. So what you're going to hear tonight is truly the hard work and culmination, really, of every year. We have a program that truly celebrates the human emotions and perseverance throughout and has all sorts of characters that kind of come into play, especially, and you'll see these in the first few pieces that we are going to be doing here. Weihnachten, which is the first piece we're going to be doing, is first of all, it's sung in German, but it literally actually means Christmas, for those who don't know. And it was a piece that was written as part of a set of, as in German, Sprüche, or really festivities, that it was just a simple celebration of joy of that particular event. And that's followed by a very different contrasting piece, the Hymn to the Virgin, which is a little bit more somber in its tone, but a little bit more awe-inspiring in its tone as well. So again, we thank you for coming out here. Please enjoy the program of the Curwensville Select Choir.
Der Heiland ist erschienen, denn der
situation such as the pandemic, when we were overrun with a lot of grief and a lot of anger, we feel, we kind of go through those stages very deeply. One of the great passages that you find in the scripture is actually from Samuel, when King David learns of the death of his son Absalom. And he is heart-wrenched, you know, to find this. And there's many interpretations you can say, but one of them simply as a parent to his child. No parent should have to bury their child. And the piece that David's lamentation speaks very much to this dripping of grief and this hard-hit emotion that you hear. But he actually took this, composer Joshua took a tune from a colonial composer, a tune that he already wrote. And he said it and kind of contemporized it a little bit to really emphasize that grief. The piece that comes after that, which really complements the piece and is really actually the response, talks about what, how we actually process that grief after it's done. The beautiful poetry, "Do not stand at my grave and weep," and it kind of talks about what comes after we kind of come across all those different stages. I'm going to ask that there be no applause. The two are actually quite connected. So I hope that you really enjoy David's lamentation as much as we have. nostalgia to the table with our next number, which will feature two of our seniors, Carly Spotsworth and Ty Thatchick. This is the classic Moon River. Tradition of doing some excellent songs from the Scottish and British Isles, and this has become one of our personal favorite, Loch Lomond. This will feature Chasey Howell and Liz Molesky.
Thank you.
Unbroken has a really, really great message. I was singing with my sisters and brothers. I was singing with my friends. And we all sing together because the circle never ends. This is probably the motto of the year, quite honestly. That just in everything that we have to do, this is what it is. You know, this is our situation. This is how we have to overcome it. And this is the piece that really encapsulates that promise. This piece will also feature Elena Anderson, Liz Molesky, and Emma Crittenden for Will the Circle Be Unbroken?
You
So we actually have one more for you that's not listed in the program. This was a song that as we were trying to figure out every year for Curwensville, as many of you know, we do a choral log, you know, which is essentially a senior choir with a really, really well-done skit that works really well with the themes of the year. And we were trying to find, obviously, the right music for this, and we came across this particular number. It's a Dolly Parton tune, Light of a Clear Blue Morning, that really encapsulates everything with what we've done here. This will feature Chasey Howell. thank you very much. It means a great deal to these students and to everyone that you are here and be able to share this with us. In the back, on the way out, you'll find that there are baskets on either side of the entrance. If you wish to donate towards the programs here at Curwensville, as well as donate towards the Clearfield Presbyterian Church for the use of their facilities this evening, anything that you give will be greatly appreciated and will help anything with our programs and anything in the future grow. Thank you so much again. Would you please give them one more round of applause? Thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening. They're going to go back and get their things, and then they are free to go. Thank you.